We're going to continue solving linear equalities using the properties of inequalities. All right, so here's a problem. 7x minus 4 is less than 3x. All right, so we solve this just like an equation, except we remember, if we multiply or divide by a negative number, then you've got to switch the inequality symbol. Otherwise, you solve it just like an equation, preserving the inequality symbol. All right, so how about subtracting 3x from both sides so that we have the variables on the left side? And let's add 4 to both sides so that the constants are on the right. So 7x minus 3x is 4x, is less than, and on the right side we'll have 4. And just divide both sides by 4 to get our solution. X is less than 1. Now, let's just do it one more time. 7x minus 4 less than 3x. What if, since you only have a constant in one place on the left side, you decided to subtract 7x from both sides so that the variables were on the right-hand side? You would have negative 4 is less than, well, 3 minus 7 is negative 4x. So if you wanted to solve for x, you'd have to divide both sides by negative 4. Well, if you divide both sides by a negative, what do you have to remember to do? That's not correct any longer. You'd have to switch the inequality symbol to be greater than. So let's see. Negative 4 divided by negative 4 is 1. 1 is greater than x, which is the same thing as saying, if you're reading like right to left, that looks like x is smaller than 1. So you want to write your answer that way. It's easier to read. And so we do end up getting the same solution. All right, so let's graph it. So it's 0, let's say that's 3, and negative 3. X is less than 1 means we've got to, let's do a marker here. So we're going to have a circle on negative 1 because that's not part of the solution. So we're going to go to the left. All the numbers to the left of 1, but it does not include 1, so you have to put a circle, not a dot, on 1 to show that's not part of the solution. Now, notice that the solution goes through 0. That means when I plug in the number 0, I should get a true inequality. So I should get a smaller number on the left and a larger number on the right. When you plug in 1, you should get exactly the same number on both sides. That's probably easy for you to do in your head. If you put in 1 for x on the left, you'd have 7 minus 4, which is 3. And you put a 1 on the right, you'd have 3. So you'd get the same number on both sides. And I bet you could put 0, do 0 in your head as well. If you put in 0 for x on both sides, this term would go to 0. So you'd have negative 4 is less than 0, which is also true. So 0 should be one of the solutions. Remembers, oops, there's the phone. Sorry about that interruption. I forgot to turn the phone off. So if we plug in 0, remember that it is a solution. And remember, there's infinitely many ordered pairs that are solutions. Okay, let's go on to another problem. All right, here's a problem. Boy, we'll get to practice simplifying both sides of an equation or an inequality in this problem. All right, so remember, you need to simplify inside parentheses first, but these are unlike terms on the left, so we need to distribute the negative 5, not just the 5, but the negative 5. So that'll be a negative 5 times 3 is negative 15. And a negative 5 times a negative 2x is plus 10x. Make sure you change both those signs inside when you're multiplying by a negative. And we need to distribute it the 4 on the right, so we have 4 times x is 4x, and 4 times 3 is 12. Now on the left side, check this out, I've got 15 minus 15, that's 0, so I have 0 plus 10x is just 10x. It's greater than or equal to 4x minus 12. All right. So that was just simplifying both sides of the inequality. Now we're going to have to isolate the variable to get the variables on the left side. Let's subtract 4x from both sides. Now remember, when you add or subtract anything to both sides of an inequality, it keeps the inequality symbol going the same direction. So 6x is greater than or equal to negative 12. And now we need to divide by 6, which is a positive number. It doesn't matter what's over on the right-hand side. What matters is what you did to both sides. And what you did was divide both sides by 6. So you have x is greater than or equal to negative 2. All right, so let's see. Here's 0, negative 4, positive 4. X is greater than or equal to negative 2. So that means it could be equal to negative 2. So we put a dot on 2. And also all the numbers to the right of negative 2 should be solutions. There's infinitely many solutions, right? All right, so now we want to check and see if that's correct. Let's make sure it's going the right direction by plugging in a 0 for x in the original inequality and making sure it makes a true equation. All right, so our solution was x is greater than or equal to negative 2. Here was the original problem. And one thing I'll let you do is when you plug in negative 2, you should get the same number on both sides. But I'm even more interested to make sure it's going the correct direction. So it's going through the number 0. So I'm going to go ahead and plug in. I'm going to check x equals 0. I choose 0 whenever I can because it's an easy number to plug in for x. So we plug in 0 for x and do order of operations on the left. So order of operations means you simplify inside parentheses first. So we've got inside parentheses, the multiplication comes first. So I have 3 minus 0, because that's 2 times 0. And we're not done simplifying inside the parentheses. 3 minus 0 is 3. Okay, now I have a subtraction and multiplication. 5 next to the parentheses means 5 times 3. So I need to do that next. 5 times 3 is 15. And finally, 15 minus 15 is 0. All right, let's do the right side. We're going to plug in 0 for x. And this will give me 4 inside parentheses. 0 minus 3 is negative 3. And 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. So the question is, we want it to be the left side to be greater than or equal to the right side. Is 0 bigger than negative 12? Yes. So we do have it going in the right direction. So this was the correct answer. I'm leaving it to you to check to make sure that negative 2 also is exactly the spot where you should put the dot. Okay, the place where the dot or the circle goes is that number that makes both sides of the inequality exactly the same. So to summarize how we did this problem, I solve it like an equation except for the fact that I keep my inequality the same unless I multiply or divide by a negative. In that case, you switch it. If you're asked to graph it, you want to graph it. Remember, if there's a little equal sign as part of it, either less than or equal to greater than symbol, it's a dot. Otherwise, it's a circle. Then you need to make sure it's going either to the right or the left. And you want to check one of those numbers that passes through and make sure the original inequality is true. Or you could check a number that it doesn't go through and make sure it comes out false. For instance, if this would have been going the opposite direction, I might check 0 and make sure 0 was not a solution. When you check it, you want to make sure that where it's going through, one of those numbers makes the inequality true. You also want to check to make sure the number where it starts, where the dot or the circle is, makes both sides exactly the same number. And that's how you solve the inequalities and check them.